So in our context, what is quality control? Quality control is a mechanism to ensure that the radiopharmaceutical is safe for administration to humans and for its intended use. Quality control essentially is a series of tests to check that the radiopharmaceutical meets its specification. These specifications are standards set by regulatory authorities, for example, the US Food and Drug Administration and the Australian Therapeutic Goods Administration. This rather busy table is an example of a product specification for the radiopharmaceutical fluorodeoxyglucose, usually referred to as FDG. Specifications for different radiopharmaceuticals can be found in pharmacopoeias, such as the British and European pharmacopoeia and the US pharmacopoeia. As you can see, there is a range of criteria that require testing. This requires a range of different test methods employing different analytical instruments. So what could go wrong in the manufacture of radiopharmaceuticals? It could be poor radio labelling of the particular pharmaceutical component resulting in free radioisotope. This can adversely affect the usefulness of the preparation. The pH or acidity, along with the isotonicity or ionic strength of the radiopharmaceutical, may be incorrect, causing problems to the patient during administration of the radiopharmaceutical. Poor radionuclidic purity of the preparation would mean the presence of unwanted radioisotopes that may result in poor imaging of the patient or unnecessary radiation dose to the patient. Poor radiochemical purity is a result of chemical species other than the desired radiopharmaceutical being radio-labelled. This can adversely affect the biodistribution of the radioisotope, impacting on image quality. The stability of the radiopharmaceutical is an important issue, as the radiopharmaceutical must continue to meet its product specification for the period of its storage and use. Chemical purity is important to consider to ensure that there is no undesired chemical components that may cause an adverse reaction or may be harmful to the patient. Also, the sterility of the radiopharmaceutical and the presence of pyrogens or fever-causing agents is important to consider to ensure patient safety. In this section, you'll gain an appreciation of how to test these product specifications using different test methods and analytical techniques. Some of the techniques include measurement of the quantity of radioactivity present using a dose calibrator. To the right, image one, is a picture of a dose calibrator. What are known as wet methods are employed for testing parameters such as isotonicity and the pH of the radiopharmaceutical preparation. Microbiological testing is performed to ensure that the radiopharmaceutical is sterile and pyrogen-free. And various chromatographic techniques are used to test various product specification criteria. The common types of chromatography used when testing radiopharmaceuticals include HPLC, or high-performance liquid chromatography, TLC, or thin-layer chromatography, and GC, or gas chromatography. Some of the chromatography equipment is quite sophisticated. Image 2 is a picture of a HPLC system used for testing the radiochemical and chemical purity of radiopharmaceuticals. This particular system includes ultraviolet and radiation detectors. Image 3 is an example of a TLC strip scanner that is used to detect and quantify the distribution of radioactive species along a strip to determine the radiochemical purity of a radiopharmaceutical. And image 4 is an example of a GC comprising a mass spectrometer that can detect small quantities of any unwanted solvents that might be present in a radiopharmaceutical preparation. The copper-coloured coil in the upper right of the image is an enlarged picture of the chromatographic column that is installed in the instrument. By the end of this section, you'll have an appreciation for what goes into the testing of radiopharmaceuticals. In particular, you'll understand the importance of quality control and product specifications along with the critical quality attributes of radiopharmaceuticals. Further, you'll have a knowledge of analytical techniques, test methods, and the instrumentation used to perform tests on samples of radiopharmaceuticals. I hope that you will enjoy this section. Thank you.